How's it going, everyone? Landon with LMR.com. Today, I'm gonna be taking a look at an exclusive fix from 5.0 Resto, and that is their instrument bezel repair kit designed specifically for the 1987 to 1993 Fox Mustangs. For those of you that have been around and have worked on Fox Mustangs, have probably started to figure out the common failure-prone areas that these cars have. Talking specifically about the 87 and 93 cars, one of the more aggravating areas that are damaged is the upper attaching points for the instrument bezel. The plastic pedestals that retain the upper portion of the bezel are sometimes broken, leaving the bezel unattached. Now, since these cars are as old as they are and they've changed hands numerous times, it's probably a guarantee that somebody broke something on the car during their ownership. Well, here at LMR, we're enthusiasts, we work on our own cars, and we like to figure out viable solutions to fix nagging problems found in Fox Mustangs. This instrument bezel repair kit from 5.0 Resto is a super simple kit that fixes most dashes that have the damaged upper attaching points. The repair brackets are made from steel and are then bent in the correct manner to ensure that the problem is properly repaired. Each bracket simply attaches to the main area of the dash behind the instrument cluster and then orientate towards the original mounting location for the upper screws. Now, because of the variables from car to car, this kit will not service cars with severe damage. To determine whether or not this kit will work for your car, follow along during the installation procedure so that you can have a better understanding on where and how the fix is accomplished. In the box will be a left-hand and right-hand bracket, a 3/16 drill bit, two short 7mm screws, two long 7mm screws, one speed clip, and of course an installation manual. As far as fitment is concerned, this repair kit will service 1987 to 1993 Fox Mustangs. In order to fix your car, start underneath the dash and loosen and remove the three 8mm retaining bolts. To remove the lower dash panel, pull straight out in one fluid motion. This will dislodge the clips from the metal support plate. Loosen and remove the two 8mm bolts, securing both the metal plate and lower portion of the instrument bezel. Of course, be sure and hold the bracket with one hand so it doesn't come crashing down. Loosen and remove the small T20 or 7mm screw from the right-hand side of the instrument bezel. Locate the two small plastic tabs tucked behind the hazard switch. Carefully depress these clips with a small flathead screwdriver while gently pulling out on the switch. Now you can carefully rotate the switch back and forth until it is completely removed from the instrument bezel. Carefully dislodge the clips, securing each electrical connection. Set this switch aside and do the same for the headlight switch on the left-hand side of the bezel. Tuck the wires into the bezel and then remove it from the car. Loosen and remove the four T20 or 7mm screws, securing the instrument cluster to the dash. Bring the cluster forward to expose as much of the backside as it allows. Push the speedo cable toward the cluster while depressing the white clip to remove it from the shaft. Squeeze the tabs on both electrical connections to remove them from the back of the cluster. You can go ahead and set the cluster aside. Notice the breaking points of the plastic pedestals on both the right and left-hand side of the dash. Being the way that ours broke, our dash is still repairable. Precisely cut the template from the instructions with a pair of scissors or a utility blade. Apply a piece of painter's tape to the backside and then stick it to the dash as shown. Position the provided 3/16 drill bit over the hole. Remove the template so that you can see what you're doing. Run the drill on low and apply very little downward pressure. It's very important that you don't damage this area. Once drilled, vacuum up any plastic shavings. If the old U-nuts are still intact, you can go ahead and remove these at this time. Of course, the car I was working on, the factory speed nuts, were long gone. Use any of the provided screws and cut threads into the repair brackets. The larger hole on the right-hand side bracket will not have threads. When doing this, it may help if you support the bracket with pliers or a vise. Take the larger of the two repair brackets and position the notched end into the dash. Align it with the hole and then install one of these short 7mm screws. You'll want to leave this screw a little loose for final adjustment. Now this screw may come in contact with the HVAC tube. However, it won't penetrate it, so don't freak out. Now on the right-hand side of the dash, install the supplied speed clip to the left-hand side of the recessed groove in the dash. Push it all the way until the base of the clip bottoms out with the edge of the dash. Mark the hole. Remove the speed clip and then carefully drill a 3/16 hole. Remember, run the drill on low speed and don't apply too much pressure. Vacuum up any shavings. reinstall the speed nut, and then align the large hole in the bracket with the speed nut. Loosely tighten another one of the short screws. Now we can check for bezel and bracket alignment. Tuck the electrical harnesses into the dash. Reinstall the instrument bezel and check the alignment. In our situation, the right-hand side was good to go. However, the left-hand side did not line up. If this is the case, remove the bezel and carefully trim away the broken plastic. Of course, to do this properly, you want to temporarily remove the screw and bracket. This can easily be done by heating up a fresh utility blade and then cutting the plastic. Of course, you can refine this further if you like, and once you achieve an acceptable finish, reinstall the bracket and the screw. Check the alignment of the bezel again, and now you should be good to go. Remove the bezel one last time and carefully tighten the two screws. Also note, depending on the condition of your car, you may have to trim some plastic on the right-hand side as well. At this time, you can reposition the instrument cluster into the dash and plug in the two electrical connections. Reinstall the speedo cable and verify that it fully engages onto the cluster shaft. Set the instrument cluster into place. Reinstall and retighten the retaining screws. I went ahead and used two of the provided 7mm long screws to retain the lower corners of the instrument cluster. Now, the reason why I did this was to utilize the factory screws that were in these locations at the top of the instrument bezel. This will ensure that this car has a factory look. On the flip side, you can do whatever you prefer. Fully tighten all the instrument cluster screws. Reposition the instrument bezel and pass the electrical connections through their respective opening. Align the top of the bezel with the repair brackets and install two screws. Be sure not to over-tighten. Reconnect the headlight switch electrical connections and reinstall the switch. Of course, do this for the hazard switch as well. Reinstall the lower 7mm screw that secures the instrument bezel support rod to the dash. Align the metal reinforcement plate and reinstall the two upper 8mm bolts. A good tip is not to over-tighten these as you could crack the bezel and the dash. Reposition the plastic trim and align the two clips with the openings in the metal plate. To fully seat the trim piece, lightly tap it into place with the bottom of your fist. Align the lower retaining points and reinstall the three bolts. Reinstall the upper and lower steering column shrouds and retighten the retaining screws. After that, you're good to go. Now, despite the little bit of work you have to do for the repair kit, it's all worth it in the end, knowing that your instrument bezel is properly secured. When drilling the dash, I can't stress enough to be extremely careful. You don't want to add insult to injury and, of course, cause further damage. Other than that, 5-0 Resto's instrument bezel repair kit is a simple, to-the-point solution for you Fox enthusiasts needing a legit fix for damaged factory mounting points. Of course, for the most current product pricing and information, be sure and reference the product page. To see more how-to and review videos covering industry-leading products, be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel, like this video, and don't forget to turn on notifications. While you're at it, check out our other videos, and of course, for all things 1979 to present Mustang and SVT Lightning, keep it right here with the real enthusiasts, LMR.com.